We hope that you are enjoying Sapphire 2023. Regardless if you were there in Orlando in person or watching key sessions online via the virtual Sapphire experience, there are plenty of announcements and details to sort through. So each year on the SAP Developer News Program, we produce these special Sapphire episodes to bring you developer-relevant highlights from the main event. And this year, there's no better place to start than with the topic of AI. AI is the talk of our industry, so of course it's taking center stage at the Sapphire event as well. The main message around AI is that SAP is utilizing AI capabilities, including emerging generative AI, to provide artificial intelligence that is built for your business. SAP is focused on delivering AI that is available out of the box and built into your most critical business functions. We take AI technology and combine that with our access to industry-specific data and deep processing knowledge, all while making it safe and reliable for your business to consume. And Sapphire showcases this approach by not only sharing details of AI technology and partnerships, but also by launching 16 new AI scenarios across the breadth of SAP's application offerings. Of those 16, 6 are also utilizing cutting-edge generative AI as well. And right here on the SAP Developers YouTube channel, we will continue to produce content that shows how our customers and partners not only can benefit from SAP Business AI, but how they can use the SAP Business Technology Platform provided AI services, such as SAP AI Core and SAP AI Launchpad, to deploy and integrate their own models into SAP applications.
Hey folks, Rich Hallman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. SAP S/4HANA Extensibility is surely a really hot topic at Sapphire this week. Customers and partners need to know how to extend their applications while still keeping the core clean. Today, I'd like to make you all aware of a recent blog post that has been published called SAP S/4HANA Extensibility Options for Clean Core Journey. Now listen, folks, just make sure you set aside some time to get through this post. It's quite extensive and contains a lot of details. The authors explain the current customer situation and challenges with the classic extensibility model, explains why S/4HANA extensibility is important while keeping the core clean, and introduces the audience to the new S/4HANA extensibility model options, including key user extensibility, on-stack extensibility, and side-by-side extensibility. This post also includes information around classic extensibility and the three-tiered approach for migrating your custom code and extensions to S/4HANA on-prem or private cloud editions. For the complete story around S/4HANA extensibility and what it means to ABAP developers, check out this blog post today.
Hola, SAP developers. I want to recap the integration-related announcements made today at Sapphire. SAP Integration Suite can support your enterprise integration needs, but there is a need to run your integrations in a private, customer-managed environment. The Edge Integration Cell allows you to do just that. It can run your integrations in on-premise data centers and private clouds, and run your integrations locally within your landscape, and now requiring these integrations to run in the cloud. Graph was added as a new capability of API management, meaning that as developers, we can simplify how our applications can easily consume data from multiple backend systems through a single API abstracting the complexity of our landscape. There's never been a better time to start your migration from SAP Process Orchestration, Process Integration, to SAP Integration Suite. The Migration Support Program has now been expanded, and it now includes regional partners and local solution advisors to help you with any questions regarding the migration. And last, but certainly not least, the SAP API Business Hub, we are all very familiar with, has been renamed to SAP Business Accelerator Hub. As you might know, we cannot only find all APIs for SAP products here, but it also includes prepackaged integrations, non-SAP connectors, reference architectures, business events, and more. I'm sharing some links in the description below where you can find additional information about these announcements.
With the ongoing success of AI, more and more use cases in various industry and line of business applications demand machine learning scenarios to be built and maintained by data scientists and embedded into the actual applications. At Sapphire, SAP announced new categories of innovations for SAP HANA Cloud. that deliver unique capabilities for intelligent data applications. This type of application applies machine learning along with the multimodal processing to business logic so that users can make quick and informed decisions. Machine learning advancements in SAP HANA include automated machine learning or AutoML and time series classifications. If you're in Orlando, then please visit the SAP HANA Cloud booth in the BTP campus at Sapphire. If you're not, then check the same demo of the intelligent data app powered by SAP HANA Cloud described by Daniel Dukes in the blog post on optimal electronic vehicle charging station placement.